First, I want to thank my ancestors. I want to thank Osir. I want to thank Oludumari, who is Dambala, who is Adam of the Bible. I want to thank the pioneers of life itself. I want to thank Eshu and Tef Nuke. This is how a universe is formed. I want to thank Geb and Newt. This is how planets and stars and suns are formed. A lot of us don't realize that a lot of hard work went into creating the universe. It was not an easy thing to accomplish. And when priests and priestesses like myself steep themselves in the wisdom of the very creation of the universe, we have a totally different perspective of life. We have an appreciation for something that we can only dream of. Most human beings can only dream and conceptualize of what had to take place for us to even get to the place where we are in this point in our evolutionary development in the universe. This subject and this area is called cosmology.
Voodoo as a religion is a very, very ancient form of harmonizing with wherever you live. The planet is alive, the lakes, the rivers are alive, the trees, the sky, the moon, the sun, all of these things are living beings. And when scientists talk about how the universe was formed, they don't give the names of these beings that were part of the formation of the solar system. But when you study the ancient Khmer and Greek and the Sumerian and the Canaanite cosmological doctrines, you have the nomenclature for the evolution of life in the universe. And that's a much more advanced and respectful way of speaking of life. So I had to prove that science isn't scientific and scientists are not scientific. You know, most Christians ain't Christian and most Muslims ain't Muslims.
Voodoo is the wisdom that birthed the universe. I had to do a whole lot of research. This is something that my family has been doing for thousands of years. I go back to my past life like I revisit yesterday. I talk to deities on a planetary level and on a terrestrial level like I talk to human beings. This is my life. I was born this way. And that's what the Oracle of Ifa says. And I'm very glad to have the privilege to write a series of books that really expound on the wisdom of voodoo. The word voodoo has several pronunciations, most misconnotations. It's a word that has been abused by the Western media conglomerates. You have to understand warfare and politics, and the people that win the war, they get to determine right and wrong. The people that win the war, they get to attach the concepts to the words that you use to define the reality that you believe in. Most people don't realize that they're going along with a version of reality that is heavily formulated and organized by a very group of intelligent people who seek to entrain your mind into a certain perspective. And I had to do a whole lot of that in my series of work.
Saying that the reason why what happened in Haiti happened is because they made a pact with the devil. That guy is called Pat Robertson, you know. The word devil comes from the word evil, which comes from the word Eve, who is a woman. So this is patriarchal nonsense, you know, and it's not that the Haitians who won the revolution didn't work with powerful goddesses, but to say that's a pact with the devil, is just more media programming of the general population. It's very, very, very bad. And, you know, we have to make our voices heard, which is the reason why I've written now three books. I've published two, which really does clarify, you know, the reason why, you know, most of what these people are saying is just to socially engineer civilization on some type of mad track.
For eternity.